Hello everyone, iCool Tech here. iPhone 7 on iOS 14.6, how well does it perform? How's battery life? Does it still overheat? Well, in this video, I'll answer all of those questions as well as let you know why you should update. Now, is your iPhone still experiencing battery drain overheating? Yes? Well, then that subscribe button below is just right for you. By subscribing with notifications enabled, you will free your iPhone 7 from all battery drain and overheating. Since updating to iOS 14.6 on my iPhone 7, performance has remained largely the same as iOS 14.5.1 and iOS 14.5. However, some users complained about decreased performance with 14.5.1, and iOS 14.6 does include a fix for that, so your experience will be different from mine in a good way if you were affected by that issue. Now, animations have remained the same as well, with only the widgets page still giving me slight stuttering issues. Now, your experience may be different as some users still report unlock stuttering with 14.5, while others have said it was fixed and this was not an issue patched with 14.6. Now, RAM management is also the same with reloads not being overly frequent, but I won't say they don't happen either. Now, before I get into battery life, I should take a second to mention that my iPhone currently has a max capacity of 90% and has had no restarts. This means that the iPhone is not being performance throttled. Now, battery life has seen some improvement for me during use when compared to 14.5.1 or even 14.5. The improvement is definitely a welcome change, and many users reported a hit to battery life as well with 14.5.1, so this may fix that for you. We're looking at standby drain of about 4-5% per night. Now, keep in mind that your battery life can and will most likely vary from mine. And as for overheating, it has not gotten any worse or better for that matter, and with this update, it still happens under very certain circumstances, but again, this is only when you're performing graphic intensive tasks, and it is only natural for that to happen regardless. Now note that after updating your iPhone software, you may experience slight battery drain and or overheating for a couple of days following. Now this is because the device has to re-index or perform many background processes post-update. Now, while everything either remains the same or does see some improvement, we're still brought back to the main question of should you update? Well, if you're on iOS 14.5 or iOS 14.5.1, update really isn't a reason not to. If you're on an early release of iOS 14, I'd say just update at this point. And if you're on iOS 13 and do need to update, I'd recommend updating, unless you seriously need good battery life and you already have it on your current release of iOS 13. If you're on iOS 13 and earlier and don't care or need to update, I would recommend staying there for now. Alright everyone, that is all I have for this video. Now if you do have any questions or you just like to say hi, make sure to leave a comment down below. Of course, definitely make sure to follow me on Twitter using the link in the description. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next one.